In this video, I am going to explain you simple React application used to create the e-commerce website. So it is a simple shopping cart. I will show you what the application is doing in here. So what we are doing is we are showing the products that we are fetching from the backend and showing the list of products here. There is an add to cart button, and you can see on the right hand side there is a cart as well. So as you click on the add to cart, it is adding this item into the cart. And as you can see, you can add multiple items like that. And if you want to view the cart, just click on this one, this button, and it will show you the list of all the items in the cart and the total as well. So it's very simple application, but if you understand this application, then it will be very easy for you to create a shopping cart or similar kind of application in React. And there are a lot of important concepts that I'm going to teach you. So hopefully you will find this video very, very useful. So you can use the syntax npx create React app, then your folder in which you want to create that application, and then template as TypeScript. So by default, the project is created in the JavaScript, but in most of the large projects, you will be using the TypeScript. So I will recommend that you use this template TypeScript so that the TypeScript project is created for you. And also you have to execute this command and make sure that this directory is already available and it is empty. So that is what we have done here. So we have got you can see this React shopping cart directory is there, and in that directory we have already created that project using that command that I just showed you. So what we have to do is in this source directory we will find this index.tsx. So that is where the execution starts. So you will be very familiar with this particular structure if you have already worked on the React project or created the React application using the standard create React app command. In here, what we are doing is we are mounting our application. You can see this app. This is a JSX component, and we are mounting this particular app on the root. So root is the HTML element. You can see here in the public directory. So public directory is also created by default when you first time created the project. And in index.html, you'll find the element whose ID is root. So our application will be mounted on this particular element. So that is what is happening in the index.tsx and query client provider. So we are using this query client and query client provider. So this is useful if you want to fetch data from the server backend and display it in your front end. So that is why we are using this query client and query client provider. As you can see, we have imported this particular file app. So let us go to that file. Let us see what is happening in that app.tsx. And also notice that we don't need to mention the extensions as well. React will take care of that. So we have to go to the app.tsx, and here a lot of magic is happening. So let me explain briefly what these imports are doing. We are using this use state use query. Now use query, as I said earlier, we have to fetch the data from the server, and that's why we are using use query. Use state is used to create a state for our application. And then there are some components, built-in components, and some are custom or the components that we have created. So this item and cart, these are the components that we have created. These are our own user-defined components, but there are some other components that we have used from the Material UI library. Now Material UI is very popular library that you can use, and you can use the built-in component. They have already developed some components that we can use as such. So we don't need to code anything. So there are some components that we are using, draw or linear progress to show the progress of our application as we fetch the data from the server. Then to show the like products in the grid, we are using this grid component. Then add shopping cart icon, we are using the icons as well. As you can see in Material UI, there is a core library and then there is icons library. So if you want to show the icons in your application, you can use this icons library. So I will show you where we are using. So the icon that you should see here, this icon, this is coming from Material UI. And then there is a badge as well that we are using. And then styles, so app.styles we are using. I'm not going to focus on the CSS right now. I'm focusing on the React scripting thing. So let us go ahead. And next thing that we have done here is we have defined the types. Now, whenever you use the TypeScript, you have to define the types for each variable that you are using. Otherwise, it will throw errors. So you can see here, we want to store the data in the shopping cart. So it will be have product ID, product name, and quantity, price, title, etc. So a lot of information is there related to the product. So all we are storing it in this particular object. You can see there is an ID, there is a category, description, image, price, title, amount. So what we have done here is we have created one object, and we have defined defined one type called as cart item type, and we have specified what types of fields it will have. Next thing we are doing here is we are fetching the data from the server using asynchronous programming, like async await syntax. So all that is happening here is it is fetching the data from this URL. So all the products are in this particular URL, and then we are fetching it and then converting into the JSON object. So it will return the array of products. So each product will have this structure. Okay, now next thing that is happening here is we have got this app function. So this is the main function for this particular component, app component. So we are using two states. One state is used to control if this shopping cart is open or closed. So that is one state. Next state that we are using is to store the data associated with your cart. Like whenever you click on add cart, you can see this cart information is being stored. So that cart is another state that we are using in our application. So you can see here there are two states: use state cart is open or not, and then there is another state which is storing cart items. And there is a set cart open and set cart items. So these methods will be used to set the state. For example, if you want to update your items in the cart, you can call the set cart items method. And if you want to open or close, you can use the set cart open method. And initial state is false, that means cart will be closed, it will not be shown, and cart items will be empty. As you can see, we are storing the empty items. Now this is an array of this type, cart item type, which we have already defined here. Next thing that we are using is we are using another hook from the React, that is use query. And this query is going to return the items or the products of this type, cart item type, in the form of array. So we have mentioned that this is the products that we are fetching from the backend, and we are calling this getProducts method, as you can see here. So getProducts will contain all the information, and then we are assigning it into the data. So whenever the server will respond with that products, it is being stored in this data variable. If while the data is being fetched, it will store this value in is loading. So is loading is true, that means data is being still loaded. If it is false, that means data is already loaded. And if there is any error, for example if the backend is down, then that error will be stored in this error object. Here we are printing this data that is coming from the server in the console, so we can see in the console as well. Then there is a get total items, there is another function which is used to get the total items in the cart. Then there is a handle add to cart. So whenever we click on add to cart button, this particular method will get called. And what is happening is when we click on the handle add to cart, the set cart items is being called. So this is actually gonna set the state of the cart item. So cart items state will be updated. And this is basically a callback function, and we are passing the previous state into that function. And in here, if the first time we are adding the product, it is just taking the previous state and then adding our new item in this particular syntax. So this syntax, let me explain you. This is actually a rest operator which is used to get all the items in that particular array. So previous is nothing but an array of the products that is stored in the cart. So we are getting all these shopping cart items and then adding our new one that was added. Now if the item is already there, then what happens is you can see the item count is added, so it is incremented by one. So we are using this map function. So map function basically what it does is that it returns the updated list of the items. So if you want to add the item, it will be incremented, the amount property will be incremented, otherwise item will be added as such, and the new cart will be created based upon this information. So you can see here we are using this find map these methods of the array. These are the standard methods that are provided by the JavaScript, and this is how we can use it. For example, if you want to find if certain item is available in the cart, then you can see this previous is basically the previous state of the cart. So we are checking that cart contains our item. So you can see here item.id is equal to clicked item.id, and if it returns true, so find method returns true if any of the item is available in the cart. So our item is there in the cart, and based upon that we can use this if condition. So if your item is in the cart, we want to update the cart in a different way. If it is the first time that we are adding that item, then we want to just add it, and then amount has to be 1, otherwise amount has to be incremented. So that logic is in here. Next method that we are using is handle remove from the cart. So whenever user clicks on the remove from the cart, what happens? So whenever user clicks on the remove item from the cart, that button, then we are again setting the state of the cart, and as you can see we are using the previous state, using the reduce method on that previous state, and the first parameter of the reduce is this one. So this is basically a callback function. Second parameter is the starting value for the reduce function. So basically what we are doing is we are populating this particular cart based upon what item was clicked, like what item customer wants to remove. For example, here we are checking if that item's ID is matching. If it is matching, then and the quantity is 1, then we are returning ACK. That means that item is being excluded from the cart. That item will not be added into the cart. So here what is happening is that item is added, but the quantity is decreased by 1, and in here item is being added as it is. So we are populating the new cart object, and in which there will be the correct cart with the updated quantity. So that is what is happening in here. Now in here what is happening is, as I said earlier, there is is loading and error. These two variables are there when we use this hook, use query. And if is loading is true, we are returning this JSX linear progress. So this is a component that is being used from the material UI. So it will just show the linear progress. So I will show you in here. So if I just refresh, so this progress that you can see here, so that is coming from the material UI. And we are using this return statement. That means as long as this list is being loaded, this linear progress will be displayed. And when the data is loaded, the list component or the application will be again rendered, and at that point of time this condition will be false, this condition will be false if the server is up and running, and then we are returning our main grid. So here we have got the drawer, this component we are rendering, but this is in the wrapper, that's why it is closed. By default the state of this cart is false, as you can see here. Or initially we initialize that state with the false. That means cart will not be displayed. There is a cart component. We are passing this cart items, add to cart, remove from the cart, these props. So these are the props. That is how you can pass the props. And cart items is a state. So that is how you can pass the state through the props to the child component. So cart is the child component, you can see here. So there is a style button. So that is where we are this code will get executed when we click on the shopping cart. So when that cart gets open, so that is what is happening here. And finally we are printing all the products. So all the products that you are seeing, they are displayed in the grid. So that is where this grid component is being used. As you can see, it is coming from the material UI, and again we are passing some props, key and access SM. So these are actually used to show or render the UI based upon the viewport. So EXS means extra small, SM means small. So XS 12 means that just one product will be displayed on the smallest device. If it is a device that is larger than that, then three products will be shown. For example, here you can see there are three products in one line. So this settings or this CSS settings will control that thing. And in that grid there is an item component, that again that is a user defined component. We are using this prop item, and item will contain everything like item price, title, etc, etc. Then there is a handle add to cart. There is another props that we are passing. So as you can see, these handlers are defined in this particular app component, which are at the top level, and that is how we are passing it through the props over child components. So these are all the child components. Now there is atom. This is a child component that I will explain you after this, and there is another component called as card as well. So let us see what is in there, that components. So card component is basically the thing that you see when you click on this button. So this is the card component, and in that card component there are card items. Okay, card item is the child of this one, and as you can see, it is showing the total as well here, and these are the props: key item, add to cart, remove from the cart. So these details are being passed to the cart item component. So let us see cart item component here, and all it is doing is just rendering the details. Here you can see the react.fc means this is a function based component which is accepting the props, props of this type. So there will be item, there will be add to cart, remove from the cart buttons or the handlers that you are passing here. And this is simple HTML. Basically it is just printing the details of this object, like product price, product amount, product for that product, and then there are the buttons like remove from the cart, add from the cart, etc., add to the cart, and image as well. So we are exporting this cart item here, and then we are using this cart item in this particular class cart. So what happens is that, as you can see, in this cart item we have got add to cart and remove from the cart on click handler. So whenever we click on that buttons, remove from cart or the add to cart, those handlers will get called, and those handlers are defined in here. So you can see handle add to cart, which I have already explained, and there is another handle remove from the cart. So all that is happening in these handlers is that our cart state is being updated. That is, item is being added or it is being removed, and then cart state will be updated accordingly. That's it. That is how you can create a simple shopping cart in your React. If you have any questions, let me know through the comments, and I will definitely try to help you. Thank you for watching this video.